Good morning, class. I trust you had a nice night. All right. Today we are looking at literature letter writing. Our strand is letter writing, and our substrand is what? Friendly or informal letters. Okay. Basically, letters are written communications, or a letter is a written communication between people or groups, or between people and groups, and between groups and groups. So therefore, when we talk about letters, we talk about written communication from one person to another with a stated message. Again, we said a letter is a written communication from one person to another with a stated message. Now, before the introduction of mobile phones, we used to rely a lot on letter writing. And basically, we have three types of letters, right? Basically, we have three types of letters. First of all, we have formal letters. Okay, we have semi-formal letters, and then we have three informal or friendly letters. Okay, for the purposes of time, we cannot explain all this, but what we are most important, or what we are most interested in, we are looking at informal or friendly letters. Informal or friendly letters. Okay. Informal or friendly letters. Informal or friendly letters are letters we often write to our friends, our colleagues, or people who are at our age. Okay. We write informal or friendly letters to our friends, our classmates, our colleagues, or people who are the same ages with us. Okay, an informal letter, like a human being or anything, has its parts. When I talk about parts, I talk about composition, okay? The various parts that will sum up together to form an informal letter. Of course, when you are writing an informal letter, the parts, you have basically six parts to an informal letter. We have, first one, we have the writer's address. Writer's address. Now look at the left-hand side of the board. I have a sample of a friendly letter here. So we have writer's address. When you look at the sample here, the writer's address is the address of the person who is writing the letter. Of course, when you write a letter to anyone, it is vital that you provide your address so that the person can also be able to write back to you if need be. Okay, now we have the writer's address. Also, we have the date on which the letter was written. Then also, we have salutation. Salutation is a form of greeting. Then we have the body of the letter. Then we have subscription. And then we have the what? Name of writer. Again, we have the writer's address. We have the date on which the letter was written. We have the salutation, which is a form of greeting. We have the body of the letter. This is where the main information is contained. We have the subscription, and then we have the name of writer. Okay, now let's come to the address again. Address again. Now, the address of a formal letter, as indicated here, of an informal letter, as indicated here, is written at the upper right-hand corner of your paper. Again, upper right-hand corner of your paper. Now, the address can be in the block form or in the slanted form. I have it here. You can look at it. The address may either be in the block form or the slanted form. Now, the difference between the block form and the slanted form is that when you look at the block form, you notice that they follow each other in a straight line, but in the slanted form, you notice that it's slanted, just as I've ruled the line there for you to see. It tells you this is a slanted one. Now, the slanted form of address can either be punctuated or non-punctuated. As you can see on the board, this is a punctuated form of block address and also a punctuated form of slanted address. Okay, Now, we also have the date. The date is written just on the next line, also at the upper right-hand corner, under the address. Now, you must note, however, that the date may be very close to the address, but the date is not part of the address. Okay, then after the date, you come to what? Your salutation. For friendly letters, salutation, like I said, is a form of greeting. For friendly letters, you write your salutation. We have dear, hello, hello, or hi. These are the three salutations we use for dear, for friendly letters. Of course, you cannot use all three in the same letter, right? But you can decide to use any of them, followed by the person's name and a comma. As indicated here, you can see dear Kwame with what? A comma. Ladies and gentlemen, I said for salutation, we have dear, hello, or hi. Then you write the person's name and then followed by a comma. Okay, having done that, then you come to the most important aspect of the letter. The most important aspect of the letter, which is the body. The body of the letter. The body of a letter often is divided into three parts. We have the introduction, the main body, and then the conclusion. The introduction often talks about exchanging pleasantries. When I talk about pleasantries, we mean that you start in a chatty way, right? Informal letters are often chatty because we write to our friends. And so you start by finding out how your friend is doing and also telling your friend how you are doing. Notice that I've given you a short one here, but in your notes, I'll bring an elaborate one so that you can use it for your reference. Okay, so I said, dear Kwame, I am very glad to write this letter. How are you? Okay, it ends there. But I could say, well, by the grace of Almighty God, I know you are nice and okay. Well, Kwame, the last time we met, we were in a supermarket. By then, you were not doing very well. But I hope you are very fine now. You notice that these are all introductions, right? Then, after your introduction, you come to the main reason why you are writing the letter. So you say, well, Kwame, the main reason for me writing this letter to you, then depending on why you are writing the letter to the person, you state that reason. It could be that you are inviting the person for the Christmas holidays. It could be also that you are inviting him for an excursion. It could also be that you are seeking his permission to visit him or her. It may be any of the above. So in the body of the letter, this is where you state categorically the reason for which you are writing the letter. So in writing the letter, the reason or the main agenda, the reason why you are writing the letter is captured in the body. It's captured in the body. Then, after you have written everything, giving the person the reason, then you come to the conclusion of the body. The conclusion of the body also often is a summation of everything you have written in the letter. And don't forget that when you are writing a friendly letter, it is assumed that you know the person for a while. And so you may also know some members of your friend's family or some of your friend's friends. So your conclusion, you could say, well, Kwame, or this letter we wrote it to Kennedy. So you could say, well, Kennedy, before I sign off, you give your friend a reason why you need to sign off, right? So you could say, well, Kennedy, I'm running out of ink. But then, please don't forget to extend my greetings to the following people. Of course, you may name two or three people you want your friend to greet for you. You don't have to list the whole class, okay? All right. Then, having done that, you come to your subscription. Subscription. For friendly letters, we have several subscriptions. You can say yours ever, your friend, your lovely friend, or any of the expressions. But for the purposes of our study today, we chose yours ever. So yours ever will be followed by a comma. And then you indicate the name of writer. Of course, so having read this, we know that this letter was written by Kennedy, right? Strangely, it is a letter written to Kennedy by another person who is also called Kennedy, right? So yours ever Kennedy. So whoever picks this letter would know that it is Kennedy who wrote this letter. And then based on the name Kennedy, you can also use Kennedy's address and then write a feedback to Kennedy for or any other thing you may want to tell Kennedy. So in our next lessons, we'll still be looking at some of these things. But as usual, I'll give you a more elaborate sample of a friendly letter so that you can use it for your references. So we'll meet again for the next lesson. You can, as usual, like we always say, put down questions that you need answering so that I'll tackle them in our subsequent lessons. Have a nice day, and this is the end of the lesson. Thank you.